the things that we need to, you know, Thursday nights, you know, get in here, kick on your knees and pray. Pray for yourselves, pray for our church, pray for our community. Because that is the only way change is going to happen. If we open our hearts and we open our minds and let Jesus take over, Jesus take the wheel as the song goes. That's the only way we'll change. That's the only way we'll grow, because we have to change here before we can grow out there. Because if we don't change here, well, we're going to continue what we're doing. And that's not working, is it? That's not bringing people in, is it? Never will. If I think Peter, when he was talking to Jesus there, I think he was afraid. Peter was afraid. That's why Peter made that statement to Jesus. You see, he didn't want to lose his friend. He didn't want to lose his teacher. He did not want to lose his Rabboni. Okay? He wanted to keep his friend, and he wanted his friend to quit talking about death. I mean, Jesus is predicting his death. Nobody wants to hear that. Nobody wants to hear that their friend is going to be gone away. But Peter didn't understand. You see, Jesus dying on the cross was him following his purpose in life. Why he came. Peter also didn't understand that there is a price to follow God's leading. Leaving our fear behind, leaving our hang-ups behind, leaving our prejudices, leaving our biases, leaving our preconceptions behind, and follow where he leads. If you want to gain your life, you lose your life. And if you lose your life, you gain life. Amen? This fact was solidified, it was proven by the second part of that scripture. Deny ourselves and take up our cross. We need to lose our life, lose our fears to save our lives, and as a matter of fact, to save other people's lives. If we let the sickness of fear continue to keep its grips around our throats, personally and collectively, we will die. We will die. If we let fear control our lives and not move out of our death clothes into the robe of righteousness. Think about this now. Jesus' victory over sin and death is sort of made null and void in our lives. Think about that for a minute. He died so we would not have fear. He died so that we would have a new life. And as if we continue to fear, then I guess it's null and void, isn't it? Just think about it for a moment. If we are afraid of the price of the cross, our cross, then how can we fulfill our call and make disciples for Christ? If we let fear control and we not move out into our calling, are we denying Jesus? Are we denying Jesus if we do not step out into our call? Are we denying Jesus? Beloved children of the Most High God, I love you all. I love myself too. But yeah. Jesus is calling us out of our tombs, of what ails us, into his glorious light be healed. What is ailing us as a church? As individuals, as one body, what is ailing us? How can we mend the fences in our hearts? How can we do that? I know that there are things that we just don't want to talk about, and that there are things that we just don't want to hear, but should we let fear stop us from being fearless Christians? Like we're called to be. Like joyless. What if hope came through our door right now? What if she came through our door right now? Would we fear her, or even worse, would she fear us when she walked through that door? I ask that we prayerfully come together as a family to heal what ails us. Let us become that group that hope can be part of, and that she can set her fears at the foot of the cross and be healed and be loved. Maybe, just maybe, she's going to come through our door. My question is this: are we willing, are we able, are we wanting to let hope